so happy to look out and see lots of familiar faces, but even better than that, a lot of unfamiliar faces. Thank you so much for coming. It's great to have you here, and we hope to see you more in the future. So, so because there are new faces, I want to explain a little bit about Tuba Bach and how this whole thing works out that these people are here today. But Tuba Bach, we are now in our 17th year of bringing what we call world-class musicians from all around the world to come here to Big Rapids and play concerts. And so today is one of those. Over the 17 years, we've had a wonderful relationship with a lot of folks from Michigan State University faculty and students that have come up and played and been part of the festival. But just this past year, sort of officialized, I don't know if that's a word, but it is now, the partnership. And so we are, so we have now an official relationship with the MSU College of Music. It's been great. So in addition to the regular Tuba Bach concerts and how they all happen, now we're bringing up another, you know, another 10 or 12 concerts throughout the year featuring students and faculty from down in East Lansing. So usually another thing that the people that come, you regulars know this, but you people don't know, is that I talk a lot when there's Tuba Bach concerts. But one of the good things about these MSU present concerts is I only get one shot, and that's right now. So at least when I'm done, I'm done. But I got a lot to say, but one of those. So, but I do want to make sure that we thank, of course, the MSU College of Music and all the folks down there that have worked with us to make these concerts happen. Emmanuel Lutheran Church for this wonderful space. That's the new home of all things Tuba Bach. So that's been great. The people behind the scenes that make things happen, Paul Hillman is back here running the live stream today, so if you are listening or watching on YouTube and Facebook, or YouTube and Facebook, I like to call them, then welcome, and glad that you are here. And Jane and Adriana that do ushering duties and all of that. Ben, intern Ben is back in East Lansing, making sure things run smoothly back there, so there's that. Those are the people I need to thank. Want to tell you about a couple of things coming up the rest of the Tuba Bach season, because we know that now. On May 1st is the last of this school academic year season. The Michigan State University Graduate Brass Quintet will be here on May 1st, right here, doing the same kind of thing, so come back for that. Our summer concert. So 2022 seemed to have a lot of twos in it, and tubas have two in it and all that, so this is a year of twos. And our summer concert is on June 19th, which celebrates two holidays. It's Father's Day and it's Juneteenth. All at one, Alvin Waddles and Dominic Waddles, father and son, are going to be playing. I get to play with Noah, so it's another father and son, and there's another father-son duo that I only found out yesterday that they're in, but I didn't find out what their names are. Coming up from Grand Rapids, and Max Colley, who's another MSU connection, is going to be up. And it's we're just doing kind of a big New Orleans Juneteenth Father's Day celebration, and with some xylophone rags and some Dixie music. It's going to be a whole lot of fun. So come up for that. And then the big festival in the fall is a lot of pairs. The first weekend, Alvin Waddles will be back, and Alvin requested that he wanted to do a whole concert of all duo piano music, jazz, classical, hybrid music. Dueling pianos, and you wanted to do that with Noah, and then also Trevor Else, who you're going to hear more from later today, is going to be up playing drums too. So that's pretty cool. The second week, Phil Sender and Derek Polishuk, that are both faculty members of the state, are coming up here. And in addition to those two, we're going to round up six more tuba and euphonium players from colleges, universities around the state of Michigan, and we're going to do some really cool tuba, euphonium, and piano things. Third week, there's a lot of percussion going on. Third week, as a duo thing, because it'll be a senior year, and I don't know what happens after that, and it might be my last shot for a while, Noah's going to come back, and we're going to do just a whole show of marimba and tuba stuff. It's going to be very cool. I'm excited about that. The fourth week, there's a group, and there's two people. Yes, I don't know. They're called Dyad. Both of them are faculty members at the Berklee College of Music out in Boston. One plays piano and sings, one plays bass and flugelhorn and sings, so they're here for that. Rod Dixon and Alfreda Burke are here the fifth week, and so they're a husband and wife duo kind of a thing, and we're going to do a lot of cool gospel music and things of that sort. And then the final week this year, Mike Stevens, harmonica, I think it's a lot of things, virtuoso, fruit of nature, those things, and more. But Mike is going to be here, and then he is pairing up with Kevin Jones, who you guys in the front row know who he is, but he's another faculty member in the percussion department down at Michigan State, and particularly a lot of hand-drawn stuff. So he's going to join in on that, and that's going to be a whole lot of fun. Those are the concerts that are coming up. There's that. Tick, 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 tick. After the concert today, just if you're interested in the second kind of an encore performance, down at the library, the Big Rapids Public Library just installed a new playground, and as part of their playground, there's one corner that's all musical exploration kind of thing. And they haven't had the grand opening yet, but as part of the grand opening, there's going to be a video that these folks that are playing for today, we're going to go over there and play on the playground and play some instruments and do some videotapes and stuff like that. It'll just be a whole lot of fun. So it's a beautiful, wonderful, nice day. This is like the best thing we've had so far in 2022, yeah? It'll probably snow tomorrow, so come to the library. Other than that, because this is my last shot, as you leave now, it was there when you came in too, but as you leave, there's one of my old tubas by the door. It does a great job taking donations. We love to do these concerts for free, but as you know, they're not really free, but they're free to you, but they're not free to us. And if you are able to help out with all those costs, we would love it. There's a special board about the big grand piano that we're doing the fundraising for this year. We are within $9,000 of having that taken care of. So if you would like to be part of that, it's almost done. We're about 85% of the way there. So that's what I have to say. Super excited to have the Michigan State University Percussion Ensemble here today under the direction of Gwendolyn Dees and John Weber. And I am going to stop talking. And are you going to talk first, or is Will going to play first? Well, it's going to be both. So Gwen's going to talk first, but I'm going to jump in first and introduce, because the first guy that's playing is my kid, Noah. There you go. I did my part. My share.
Hi, everyone. My name is Gwendolyn Dees. I'm the director of percussion at Michigan State University. And we're super excited to be here to play this concert for you. So as I was making the program, I thought it might be nice to start with a familiar face to a lot of you all. So this is Noah Millett, and he's going to be playing a piece that he just performed last week on his junior recital. It's called Velocities by Joseph Schwantner, and it's one of the sort of staple difficult pieces in our marimba repertoire for five-octave marimba. So hopefully you enjoy that. It's a more modern piece, but there's a lot of pretty sort of pleasant tonalities to listen to as well. Also, just a lot of fast playing overall for the whole week, so it's pretty fun. After Noah plays, Michael Junta, who's one of our graduate TAs over there, is going to play a piece of Bach on the marimba, kind of along the lines of the Tuba Bach Festival. Also, Bach sounds great on the marimba, at least a lot of us think that. And this is from one of Bach's violin sonatas. It's a fugue from the G minor sonata, although Michael has done kind of an arrangement of it. So if you're familiar with this piece, you'll hear some extra notes that kind of fill it out. It's a little bit more like the lute suite that Bach wrote of this piece than it is the marimba version. So those are the first two pieces, and then I'll be back to talk a little bit more. Thank you. All right, there we go. Okay, next up, we've got Jacob and Blake and last minute addition of Trevor, so he's not in the program. Trevor will be playing drum set with them. They're going to be playing a now trio, but originally a duo called Parkour and I by a composer named Andy Kehoe. This is a newer piece, and Andy is becoming a really popular composer for percussion. And Jacob just performed this last night on his senior recital, so he is going to explain a little bit of what's going on in the piece and what to listen for to you all.
Hello, everybody. This piece is Karakuranai. It's Japanese. It's Karakuranai, and it's Japanese for foreign crimson. So this piece was originally written for the synesthesia suite, and for those of you who don't know, synesthesia is when you associate one sense with another. So for example, if you hear the name Alex, you might see the name, or see the color green. So he's trying to create an image where you see the color crimson. And in this piece, there is a constant ostinato in the right hand that has 31 notes in it, or 31 counts in it. So eventually, it lines back up with the melody, but it does take a while. So I hope you guys enjoy Karakuranai. Thank you.
Matsuri drums by Keiko Abe. Keiko Abe is a really big famous composer for us percussionists. She wrote so many pieces and commissioned a lot of pieces too. And she's one of the first sort of marimba virtuosos that we have. And so she's from Japan. She started playing over there, and then her performances and her compositions got discovered over here and sort of started a big revolution of playing and composing and commissioning over here. So she's written a lot of pieces, and this is one of her unique ones because most of her pieces are for four mallets, but this one is written for two mallets, and it's for two really specialized mallets. They're called slap mallets. And so Lorenz got them right there. You want to hold them up and then demonstrate what they sound like? Yeah, so they're almost like little pillows covered with chamois or leather or something like that. And they're supposed to have a very slappy tone when you hit the marimba. And they have another side to them that's almost like a little xylophone mallet. So she wanted to really experiment with the different sounds you could make on the marimba. This particular piece is really inspired by taiko drumming from Japan. And so it's a perfect fit for Lorena because she's actually been to Japan and has studied some taiko drumming. And she's going to go back this summer and actually is going to get to study with Keiko Abe, which is going to be super exciting. Yeah, so that's going to be awesome. So I hope you enjoyed that one. And then after that, you'll hear Shinny, and she's going to come up and play a piece called Komodo. And one of the exciting things about this piece is it's for six mallets. And so far, you've mainly been hearing seeing four mallets on marimba and some two mallets, and that's mostly what's common, although a lot of players do know how to play a little bit with six mallets. But one of the very cool things about Shinny is that she not only kind of knows how to play with six mallets, she really knows how to play with six mallets. And to be honest, there's really not that many people in our field at all who really know how to play with six mallets. She's maybe the best that I've seen of anybody. So you'll get to hear her play in a minute with Komodo, and then again at the end in her piece Solarmist. So here are these two pieces. Thank you.
John Miller, I also teach percussion at Michigan State, and I'll also say that we're very grateful to be here to play for you today. Our next group is going to be featuring some of our freshmen that are here to play for you. We're going to play some ragtime pieces. These pieces were composed by George Hamilton Green in the early 20th century. These pieces for xylophone. Xylophone was very popular at the beginning of the 20th century. It worked really well with the recording equipment at the time. You didn't get a whole lot of bass and everything. So right in the very beginning of the 20th century, ragtime was popular from composers such as Scott Joplin. And one thing about George Hamilton Reed also, has anyone heard of Steamboat Willie? That cartoon was the first Walt Disney cartoon with sound. George Hamilton Green was the xylophone player on that. If you remember, it's like cow's teeth and the hit of this. Anyway, so George Hamilton Green composed these pieces, and then they were made popular again, kind of a revival by Bob Becker, who did these arrangements, and he was a part of a percussion ensemble called Nexus. And in the 70s and 80s, they started playing these pieces again, and it became very popular, at least in the percussion world. So we're going to feature Aaron on the first one and Peyton on the second one, triplets, and hope you enjoy these pieces.
Thank you. Thank you. Like this before me was really tall.
Thank you.
Okay, so while they're sitting up for this last piece, I just want to say thank you again for coming. I think we've had a great time playing for you all, and thank you to Ed and Millette for having us out for this concert. It's been super fun, and hopefully we'll be able to come back at some point. So, yeah, thank you for coming. If you have any questions, if you'd like to come up and talk with any of us afterwards, I'm sure we'd all be happy to answer questions or show you any of the instruments or balance or anything that we've been playing with, so feel free to come up and ask questions or anything like that. So this next piece takes a little bit of setting up. It's the largest piece that we have for you today. So Shimmy, who played the six mounts before, is going to be featured on the marimba solo part. And then we have Michael and Blake and Doug who are going to accompany her. And this is a really unique piece because not only is it a percussion piece, but it also has a lot of theatrical elements too. So we're going to be using this whole stage, and they're going to be moving around a lot. And one of the interesting elements in this piece is there's going to be a lot of tension between the marimba player and the percussionist, and you're going to see them sort of, quote, fighting in different ways. And they're also going to be using a lot of interesting things as instruments. So you'll see, I'm gonna borrow these really quick. Them using these fans. They're actually going to use these as instruments. I will show you how they do it. I haven't practiced this data. But this is pretty cool how they use these as instruments. They're going to be playing all over the stage. Shenny has some pretty cool extra things that she's going to bring in. I hope you really enjoy this piece. It's super fun. And thank you again for being a great audience. And I think they're pretty close to being set up, so we will get started.
Thank you.